How long is the average healing process for birthmark removal on the neck? This is, well, first of all, the word birthmark doesn't have to be there. So it could be how long is the average healing process for lesion removal on the neck, because whether it's a birthmark or whether it's a mole or whether it's a tattoo, you know, it's removal of a piece of skin on the neck, basically. And secondly, I won't say get criticized, but I can understand how people can get frustrated and say, well, how much does it cost to have a birthmark removed? Because the answer is it does vary. And birthmarks can be little things. They can be brown, they can be red, or they can be big. So basically they can vary in size, and that will affect the healing time. If it's a big lesion and it's closed under a lot of tension, you know, the neck's obviously moving, so there's a risk that you can get issues. The good thing about the neck is there is quite a lot of skin laxity, but there is skin laxity there for a reason, because you need to kind of move your neck around. So it's one of those. But you can remove a certain, you know, a reasonable amount of skin from the neck without too much tension. So the tension is important in terms of the healing. So the less tension is under, the better, and the quicker the healing. But in general terms, for removing a lesion from the neck, be it a birthmark or whatever, usually the skin's healed in about a week. So on places like the neck, we probably put a little dressing on there, and the dressing stays on for a week, and then the dressing comes off, and the skin's usually healed in a week. Now, the skin's healed, which means that you normally don't need a dressing. I say usually, because sometimes there's little bits that aren't healed, especially if we use dissolvable sutures. There can be little bits where it hasn't dissolved properly, and there's little red areas and raw bits. But broadly speaking, the skin will be healed in a week. So that means you can wash, you can shower, and you don't normally need a dressing. So you normally need a dressing in for a week. Usually, well, I wouldn't say usually. The next one of those ones where you'd often use dissolvable sutures. You might use removable sutures. If you use removable sutures, they would, again, come out after about a week, because that's around the time that the skin heals. So skin healed in a week, but it won't be full strength. So whilst the skin will be healed, you can't kind of go back to normal activities and start, you know, going to play rugby or whatever. So you need to take it easy for a few weeks. Now, the scar is probably not going to be up to full strength for a few months, but I would say you've got to take it easy for a few weeks and then gently get back into things. As a general rule, we normally say 6 weeks before you start massaging the scar. The scar is often quite firm at 6 weeks, more firm at 6 weeks than it was at 1 week, because the scar is kind of strengthening. The more tissue is going into to reinforce the scar, your body is making that scar stronger, which is good, but it makes it quite red, raised and thickened. So it can look more unsightly whilst it's getting stronger. And then it goes through a process called remodeling, which is the redness fades, the thickness thins, and it goes into hopefully a fine white line. But it takes several months to get there, and massaging it in that time can help. And while it's going through that active process, you don't get suntan on it, because it will leave you with a tanned scar. So a week specifically for the skin healing, I would say a few weeks before you do anything too strenuous. A lot of this is guided by your body. If it feels tight, if it feels uncomfortable, don't do it. If it feels okay, it's okay. So listen to your body, and a few months for the redness, the firmness of the scar to sort of fade, to go more skin colored. Generally speaking, all under the umbrella of kind of depends on how big it is and how tight it is and how well it heals. Some people heal better than others, and you know, there might be some delayed healing and some issues that set things back. So it can vary. But that's a general whistle stop tour of healing of a birthmark on the neck.